Well, good morning, everybody, and welcome to NASA's Johnson Space Center. You're looking at the International Space Station Flight Control Room here in the Mission Control Center. This is Tuesday, December 27th. Aboard the International Space Station, the Expedition 30 crew is on board the station as a team of flight controllers here on the ground, watches over their shoulders throughout their workday aboard the complex. The current crew aboard the station augmented this past week with three more crew members, includes Commander Dan Burbank and Flight Engineer Anton Shklaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin from Russia, along with Oleg Kononenko, Andrei Kuipers from the Netherlands, and U.S. astronaut Don Pettit. Those last three have become the newest additions to Expedition 30 aboard the International Space Station. They arrived at the complex back on December 23rd, on Friday morning, and they'll be aboard the station until May of next year. The six crew members are supported on the ground by flight control teams around the world. The team here in Houston today is being led by a veteran flight director, Royce Renfrew. He is in the white shirt, serving as the overall management link between the International Space Station Flight Control Team here in Houston and all of the other flight control teams around the world as well. Serving as the primary communications link, the voice between this team and the crew on board the station, is Jeremy Hansen. The six crew members on board the station arrived at the station at different times. The three of the crew members, Dan Burbank, Anton Shklaplerov, and Anatoly Ivanishin, arrived back in mid-November. They're enjoying their 44th day in space today, 42 of those aboard the International Space Station. The three newest members, Oleg Kononenko, Andrei Kuipers, and Don Pettit, are 6 days into their six-month voyage aboard the station, four of those days now aboard the International Space Station since arriving this past Friday. They have been spending a good deal of the weekend acclimating themselves to the station environment and also having reference meetings with the other three crew members on the station, orienting themselves to the complex. And of course, this being a holiday weekend, the Christmas celebrations aboard the station obviously allow the crew members to have the weekend off primarily, and they spend a good deal of time talking with their families and the flight control teams around the world, with good holiday wishes going back and forth between the flight control teams, the crews on board the station, and of course their family members as well. So a quiet weekend for the crew. They get back into experiment work on board the station, maintenance activities as well, exercise, and also some additional onboard training of the three newest crew members that arrived this past Friday.